No work today. You're the only one in chat. I had to go to court this morning to have this day cleared up. Didn't know how. Oh, hello. There is one person in chat besides Zero. Okay. I wonder why it only says one, two. Hey, Mighty Asylum, how are you doing? Yes, I did change the name. Change it just a couple days ago. 3 or 4 days. Also added a noise gate to the mic. Does it sound any different to you, Zero? I'm doing well, Osylum. Today I'm working on this guy. This Mind Flare. But yeah, if you check the Instagram or the portfolio or anything, you'll see I've been pretty busy, time permitting. Louder and more clear, okay. Yeah, I set up the gate. It's on the default setting, so it should get rid of some of the quieter noises, but it'll still pick up real noise. And I switched over to, I found out that Nightbot could do shout outs. You just have to program it in. But I switched over to Streamlabs. So we do work right. Working. The Streamlabs variable is different than Nightbot variable, so I still have to fix that. I'll fix that in the middle. In a minute. Maybe stream tonight. Maybe. Depends on having my birthday dinner tonight, so it kind of depends on how. Yeah, tomorrow's technically my birthday, but we're doing the dinner tonight. Because I am working tomorrow night. Thank you. I found out today. I've been telling people all year I was 53, except I'm only just now turning 53. So I just gained a whole year of my life. Pretty excited about that. It's pretty funny too. Yeah, that's the way I think about it too. Twenty-five is a good age. See how easy it is to make a mistake when we don't keep track of our own ages? We start telling people we're something else. always have to ask my wife help. But I could swear, like I can promise, I haven't told a single person that I was 52 this year. Everyone that asked, I said 53. Funny. First thing that goes is your memory. Asylum, what have you been up to? Have you been taking a break? Taking a break just from Twitch? Or just from streaming yourself? Or what? Oh, just changing time. Yeah, zero. I'm not real big on. That's a good thing. Physically, I might be 40 still. Can't complain about that. Oh, you got sick and needed surgery. Wow, yeah, that's a big deal. That's not just changing your calendar or anything. Big deal. All right. I'm glad you're back then. Glad you're doing okay. Everything okay after the surgery? Complications out. You can eat again. If you couldn't eat before, did you lose weight while you were recovering? Lots of folks lose weight after surgery. lost 30 pounds and gained it back again. Thanks, Zero. You know how it goes, right? Keep plugging away and hopefully it's on a good track. So far, I've been lucky. Lucky, lucky, lucky. Oh, gallbladder. My sister had her gallbladder removed. Did you have your gallbladder removed? I'll tell you from my own personal experience, the more you create, the easier it will become to keep creating. It's kind of like an acquired habit. Because I used to not draw very much. I would do a little bit and then it kind of burned out and then wouldn't do anything. But nowadays, I always want to do more. So I think, you know, just force yourself to do a little bit. Like we've said many times, and over time, you'll find that it gets easier to draw as you get more excited. More. Proud of the longest gallbladder in your family. And why not be proud? Now, do you guys have your gallbladders replaced because of genetics or because of dietary? Lucky chap, so far my gym required me to lose anything like that. 17, wow. All right, see you when you get back. So would you say, Asylum, that you're back 100%, or are you still mending? I saw you stream a while back, a few weeks. Well, it must have been, you know, certainly before you had your surgery. And I don't know how big your stream was when we first met. Seems like your stream was growing pretty rapidly. Have you been streaming a long time, or you just had a lot of growth this past year? Or both? 6 to 12 months for digestion to regulate. Then there's a hiccup here and there, but overall feel good. All right. Oh, wow. Streaming for 3 years. Streamed a whopping officially 5 months now. Experiment is slightly before that. It was like I've been here forever, in a good way. Remember, I've only been here 5 months. Oh, only been streaming art in September. Yeah, okay. Yep, know what you mean there. Which is kind of addictive in a way. I like the social interactions as much as I like the art. Yeah, today's a little different. I still stream late at night because that seems to be the only time I can consistently stream. But today I had to go to court. So I took the day off from all my other jobs just to make sure I had court time, you know, plenty of time for court. And so then I came home, took a nap because I stayed up all night. And then I'm like, okay, now I've got some time, I'm going to stream. So yeah, this is the first midday stream I've done in a long time. Like, months and months and months. Well, somewhere in that 5 month period. Probably 5 months ago. So yeah, this will be a surprise for anyone who finds me today. Yeah. My body pretty much wants to stay up till 4. I could stay up later, but 4 a.m. is a very natural time for me. Me working late night shifts is not helping my natural sleep schedule, making it worse. So I feel like I want to stay up all night, practically every night now. But I'm getting by. Getting by. Yeah, no problem. I always appreciate a lurk. Today's stream is still gonna be relatively short anyway. So I have family coming over around 6. I'll stream at least till 5, another hour, or until I'm done. I might actually be done with this image pretty soon. It's pretty damn close. So I might start something new or just see if other people come and hang out or play by ear. Always have. Hey, so you said you're coming to San Diego for a vacation, huh? When are you planning that trip? I think what the weather's like in November, it might get kind of on the cold. I think August is a better bet because then you can enjoy the warm weather. I know things start cooling down the end of October. Yeah, I have to experiment. I'm not sure it works that way. Although one person told me, well, only one person, said that lift doesn't work that way, so you can't really control who you call. But Uber might work that way if you just call the Uber when the driver is closest to you, and they might get pinged. I've never tested it. And if you get Ubered all over town, I don't know, that's going to be pretty expensive. Yeah, that's basically what I heard. Lyft, they give you whoever. I don't think you can truly select with Uber though, because I've had people try to call their friends when I'm Ubering, and because I was closest, it kept pinging me. But things change all the time. So who knows how it's set up right now? I don't. Well, folks like San Diego because of the weather more than anything else. Because it has is historically got the most moderate weather. It's one of the most moderate weather places on the planet. So, a lot of folks from Chicago come out here because the winters just become too much for them. And then they have a winter out here and they're like, oh my God, why didn't I do this sooner? It's almost like retiring to Florida. You know, you just go to where the warm weather is. But the other thing that's good about San Diego is that it's close to a lot of things. So there are some mountains nearby so that you can go skiing in a 2 hour trip. You can go hiking in the mountains in a 1 hour trip. You can go to the beach, usually in a 30-minute trip. You got Mexico down south, which has some cool stuff to go see. LA up north, which is a 2 hour drive, so lots of stuff in LA. You don't have to fight the LA crowd as much because it's San Diego, not LA. And, we got some good museums, super good nightlife. I mean, our downtown district has become world famous. Good place to hang. What else besides the museum? But then you get to the point, you're like, okay, I've seen it all. What else is there? That's the downside. Like, you can see all of San Diego. Like, if you moved here, you would see everything in the first year, and then that's it. You're like, okay, I've seen it all. Yeah, I was at Chicago. Maybe it might have been 12 years. And I went to try to find its nightlife. And I went to this little district that was a couple blocks by a couple blocks. But I was very surprised at the Chicago nightlife. At least what I found was so limited. But I might not have been in the hot part of town either. But I know it was. When within walking distance of downtown, I walked there, it's probably like 12 blocks. Boys Town is the ultimate nightlife spot. That's more up north of downtown. I don't know if I went north or not. Is it like within 12 blocks? Walking distance? 10 or 12 blocks? Maybe that's where I went. Because I went to wherever someone recommended. Yeah. No way. Yep. Missed out on the nightlife then. Yeah, I think so. I think the potential for Chicago to have a better nightlife is there. And have to experience both cities and determine for yourself. Maybe. Talking to a fr new friend, how you don't want to keep living a miserable, unhappy life, especially when I turn 25. Life sucks for me, and I don't want that to be forever. Oh, of course. Of course, you don't want it to be forever. And you should do whatever you got to do to make changes, too. It does seem like you're doing better day to day. My point of view, you sound better. So I think you're on the right track. I think the one who needs to see it is you. If you're seeing it, that's a good sign. Well, every day is a challenge. And every day you have to remind yourself that you're doing better. And then you won't even have to remind yourself, you'll just be better. Hey, thank you for that host, as always. Autosave messes me up every time. How's it working? Yeah, now it's it helps. What little I can do. Does that look long? Right. All right, you and your back. Oh, great. Thank you. Sorry. Trying to draw Polaris. What is that? Okay. Yeah, that'd be cool. Yeah, I'll check it in a minute. I'm on a roll adding freckles. I'm like, why can't a mind flare have freckles? So added freckles. For modded mottled skin. Thank you. Yeah, most everything I do is always solid colors, right? So I just wanted to add something. I don't know. Texture, but I'm like, why can't he be a spotted thing? So that's what I'm working on. I've got it on its own layer, so I can just get rid of this if it doesn't work, or screen it back. Might screen it back. Maybe as always, go 50% instead of 100%. That's subtle. This. So I think a little touch up on the eyes, and then I'm done. Do what to do. Anything. Doesn't show up. So it's got to be light to color. I think I'm done. I think this is going to be it. Oh, let's check out your art now. Dun 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 dun. Hey, you're getting the costumes down. All right, that is Polaris. You want it on stream or off stream? I always like putting it on stream. Yeah, the owl's next. Do 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 do. Have to change scene to desktop. There you go. So cool. Yeah, it's looking good. Figure work's looking really good. Hair's looking really good. Cool stuff. I always liked Polaris as a character. It's sort of stylistic. Her calves are kind of balled up, like she's flexed. Like this leg looks pretty good. I mean, lots of comic book artists would draw a calf exactly like that. This one can be just drawn, just maybe extended a little bit so it matches a little bit more of what you got over there. Because this part of the leg is a little bit on the long side right there. See, this one, I look at this one, think it's fine. This one and the calf a little bit, and you. Because really, what's most important is that your legs look similar to each other. Not that they have to be realistic per se, but they look similar to each other, because then it becomes a stylistic choice as opposed to an anatomy choice. Cool stuff, man. All artists are perfectionists. And like I said, you'll never really be happy with your art because you'll always see things that you do or redo or, a lot of artists will sit there and rework a drawing until it's perfect. I'm more like, I'll do a drawing until I'm happy with it and then try to learn for the next drawing to make the next one better. Like I want the tentacles to be some kind of. I'm going to add another overlay. That's 100% for now. Put normal, 100% normal for now. And let's select it. Let's go crazy on purpose. Let's see. Let's just see. Just experimenting now. But what if this is way, way, way. Don't panic. What if all of his tentacles blood tip? Pretty hot. Oh, I like that. That's a great way to look at it. I'll make a note of that. What stylistic versus, realistic. You still want to get the anatomy right, but yeah. In each individual drawing, you want it to look like it fits this drawing. I like that. I was thinking of the Mind Flayer might have blood-stained tentacles reaching into the souls of. Maybe the blood never comes off. I think that's done. Now I just have to decide. I know I don't want to draw a background, but I have to decide if I'm going to do background on gray or background on that paper text. Or even. First, I have to isolate. Well, first, I'm going to save it. That's it. I'm going to save it. All right. That. Heading out. Okay. Yep, I'll try to stream tonight. It'll be a new drawing since this one's going to be complete. Black background looks wicked. Oh. All right, I think that's the stream. I forgot I'm actually still streaming. That's pretty funny. So, for anyone who's out there, thank you for spending your time with me. I'm going to stream again later tonight, so if you liked what you saw, come on back then, and I'll do some more. So, I hope everyone has a great day, what's left of it.